In this video, I am going to explain basic anatomy of foot bones and ankle movement and little bit advanced movement of ankle joint. First of all, I am going to explain the each bone. This one is tibia, very big bone. Then lateral to the tibia, this is lateral side, this thin bone is fibula. Tibia and fibula. Below the tibia, there's a talus. This bone is very interesting. In most of the case in human bone, the most of the bone have a muscle attachment, but talus does not have muscle attachment. Anyway, this is talus. In between tibia and talus, there's a joint, actually on fibula as well. This joint is tibio-tala joint. In this place, there's a lot of movement going on. I will explain later. Tibia, fibula, talus. Here, this is talus. And below the talus, there is a calcaneus. This is heel bone, very wide bone. In human body, the ratio in between calcaneus and whole foot is very big. What does it mean? Anyway, in human, calcaneus is big. Why? Because we are bipedal creature. We use two legs to sustain whole body weight. In quadrupeds, animals, they don't have to bear the weight. So their calcaneus is relatively short. But in human body, calcaneus is very big. Tibia, talus, calcaneus. And there's a joint right here. This joint is subtalar joint. Subtalar joint. Tibia, talus, calcaneus. And let's go back to the front view. This is talus. In front of talus, this bone is navicular. Navicular. This is on medial side. There's a bone on lateral side, this one. This one is in front of calcaneus. This is cuboid. It looks like the cube shape. That's why this is cuboid. Navicular, cuboid. In front of navicular, there are three bones. These bones are cuneiform. Medial cuneiform, intermediate cuneiform, and lateral cuneiform. Medial, intermediate, and lateral. Then, in front of cuneiform and cuboid, there are metatarsal bones. Five metatarsal bones. Then, in front of metatarsal bones, we have toe bones. So, talus, calcaneus, navicular, cuboid. Three cuneiform, five metatarsals, and toe bones. Then I will explain the movement of ankle joint. This movement is dorsiflexion. This one is plantar flexion. Dorsiflexion, plantar flexion. Now as you see, this plantar flexion, dorsiflexion happens in this joint. What is this? This is tibio-talar joint. Dorsiflexion, plantar flexion happens in tibio-talar joint. And there are two other basic movements. Inversion, eversion. Inversion, eversion. It looks like it happens in tibio-talar joint, but it's not. It happens here, subtalar joint. Inversion, eversion happens mostly in subtalar joint. Inversion, eversion. So these are basic movements. There are two more very complicated movements, but I'm not explaining in this video. For the advanced mechanics about dorsiflexion and plantar flexion, as you may notice, the width on the anterior part of the talus is wide. On the posterior side is narrow, as you see. The back side is narrow. Front side is wider. So when you dorsiflex, the bigger side goes this way. That means tibia covers wide side. So the tibia and fibula should open up as they go to anterior, which is dorsiflexion. In dorsiflexion, these joints should open up. Why? Because this is wide. In plantar flexion, should go normal. As tibia covers during the dorsiflexion, the attachment surface is greater in dorsiflexion. That means in dorsiflexion, ankle joint get more stabilization compared to plantar flexion. Less surface, less stability. That means when people play the ballet, plantar flexion position, they are easy to get ankle sprain compared to dorsiflexion position. Again, during dorsiflexion, this should open up. More joint contact surface, plantar flexion, not much contact surface, which means less stability. So this can adapt to mechanics of ankle sprain. So this is today's video. I hope you liked this video and understand the anatomy of foot. And if you liked it, please like, comment, and subscribe.